a thing that the human eye can't see, but I know it's real, cause it's alive in me. It gives me courage when I need it most. I'm talking about the power of the Holy Ghost. We are
pray, pray, pray down the power. Pray, pray, pray down the power. Pray, pray, pray down the power. Pray down the power in Jesus' name.
Take this opportunity to say that I appreciate you watching us online or visiting us in service. It's also always a privilege. I had somebody stop by this Wednesday night and say to me that they'd been watching us online and how that the Word of God had touched their hearts, and that humbled me. And I pray that I can always preach the truth in love but also preach with conviction. So I appreciate you watching us. If you feel a desire and ever feel like the Lord's speaking to you to give to our local church ministries, I encourage you to do that. You can do that by going to easytithe.com and finding Prospect Church of God there. And you can do that. And I believe there's a QR code there that you can use there that take you directly into our giving website. We appreciate that. We are a small church with a big heart, and trying to do ministry is tough in the day we live. So I would encourage you to do that if at all possible. And not asking you to take tithe from your local church. Your tithe belongs to your local church, not ours. But maybe there's an offering that you would feel like giving to our church. And I'd really appreciate that. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. It's good to see everyone here this morning. Praise the Lord. What a beautiful day the Lord has given to us. Just thank Him for all His blessings. Let's all stand and we'll open up with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to You just praising You and glorifying You and lifting Your name up, God. And I pray for this service this morning. The Holy Ghost will have His mighty way, that everything will be said and done for the glory and honor of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Be with us as we worship You in spirit and in truth. Lord, I pray for the pastor this morning as he brings us the word, Lord. Anoint our ears and hearts to receive the word, oh God. And I pray the Holy Ghost will do a work here today, that he'll have his way here today. Lord, if anyone is lost, that they'll come to know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Lord God, and those that watch by Facebook and YouTube, I pray you'd bless them. And those that are lost that watch on Facebook and YouTube, that they would receive Jesus Christ as their Lord and as their Savior. And we give you all glory, honor, and praise. We pray you'd just be with us today, Lord, and have your way here today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good to see all of you this morning. How's the Lord? On this beautiful day that the Lord gave us, and what an honor it is to be in the house of the Lord, to worship and to magnify His name. We welcome all of those on Facebook, YouTube this morning. Thank you for all that you do and watching us and supporting us, and we thank you for that. And had a great couple of days on the mountain with our men. There were several of us went this time. And we had about 300 men up there, 300. And it was just, it was dynamic. It really was. And if you look on my Facebook page, you'll get to see Richard riding a horse. Amen. And get to see him riding a horse. And we just had a lot of good times, but great services. And the Lord just touched a lot of people. And that was an exciting couple of days. My wife's not here today. I had to take her to Kingsport while I was up there. I miss her so much. It's been a long week. I left there and drove all the way down to Caleb's, about an seven-hour drive down there to help take care of his car, and then had to turn around and go back to the mountain for the men on the mountain, and just got home late yesterday evening. So I'm glad to be here, but I'm going to get that woman tomorrow. Going to go get her tomorrow. So would you stand with me? Let's pray. And what a good week we had last week. Last Sunday was just dynamic. Last Sunday morning, it was amazing that we have baptized an 81-year-old gentleman that never knew the Lord in water baptism. Then on Sunday night, a 40-year-old man got filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Chris got filled with the Holy Ghost on Sunday night. That same Lord is here today. Same Lord is here today, wanting to do great things for us if we will allow Him to and give Him that opportunity. So let's let Him. Ushers, please come. Receive our... If you notice, I don't have my tithe to put in this morning. It's because my checkbook is in Kingsport, Tennessee, and I'll have to do that online this week. I like for you to see me do what I ask you to do, and so I ask you to give this morning. We need you to give, and we thank you for it. Be a giver. Be a giver. Be a tither, and we'll thank you for that. Amen. Chris, pray, would you? Thank you.
this morning. Thank you, Lord. And we sing, Majesty. Thank you.
we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Let your voice be heard, let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy
tough week. Does anybody ever go through tough weeks? Just tough days? You come from the mountain down to the valleys. Don't anybody know what I'm talking about? Financially, physically, just mentally. Just is anybody, am I the only one that ever has a week like that or days like that? This is one of those mornings I kind of need people just to lift my arms up like they did for Moses. I want us to sing that song again this morning because I need heaven just to open up for me today. I need heaven just to open. I want you to stand back up. I want us to sing it again this morning. Don't be lazy on me. Get up. Amen. And let's sing that one more time and say, God, open up heaven in this place this morning. Would you do that, Sister Lisa? Would you really sing that with us this morning? Would you?
Rain down, rain down, oh, comforter and friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain.
Let your voice be heard.
Come and change our hearts
as we stand on your word.
Holy Spirit,
rain down.
I sing it one more time. Hallelujah.
No eye has seen,
no ear has heard,
no mind can know what God has in store.
So open up heaven, open it wide, over your church and over our lives.
Holy Spirit,
rain down.
Oh, for no eye has seen,
no ear has heard, in store.
So open up heaven,
open it wide,
over your church
and over our lives.
Holy Spirit,
rain down.
Would you give him praise in this place today? Would you give him thanks and glory and honor that he deserves? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Reach over to your neighbor before we're seated this morning. Take him by the hand or lay your hand on their shoulder and just say, God, open heaven for him today. Open heaven for him today. God, pour them out a blessing. Pour them out a blessing today, God. Pour them out a blessing today, God. Hallelujah. Pour them out a blessing today, God. Pour them out a blessing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Spirit, rain down. No eye has seen, no ear has heard. Open it wide over your church and over our lives, Holy Spirit, rain down.
Amen. Give him loud praise this morning, would you? You do know when things happen like happened last Sunday, the enemy, like I even said last Sunday morning, came against Nehemiah in such a way to get him to quit building the wall. How many know when good things happen, that's when the enemy is going to do everything he can to come against the church and come against you individually? But I'm glad that God can open the windows of heaven over our lives and pour us out blessings that we cannot contain. Amen. Our children can be dismissed this morning. They will be doing a special on Easter Sunday morning. And so pray for them this morning and pray for our children's leaders. And
we bring sacrifice of praise to the house of the Lord. And we offer up to him the sacrifices of thanksgiving. And we offer up to you the sacrifices of joy.
Amen. Amen. They're having a good time, ain't they? Amen. Sister Lisa and Alan's son, Ryan, will be preaching tonight in their evening service. I asked Ryan to preach this afternoon. So he's going to be bringing the word for us this afternoon. And looking forward to that. There's no greater honor than to hear your child preach. There's just not any other honor in the world better than hearing your son or your daughter preach the word of God. And so we look forward to that. If you have your Bibles, won't you turn back with me to the book of Nehemiah this morning. Nehemiah, we're going to go to chapter 6 today. Nehemiah chapter 6. We're awful quiet this morning. We're just awful quiet. Turn to that person beside you and say, "You look too good to be quiet." Amen. You just look really too good today to be that quiet. Nehemiah chapter 6. We're going to start in verse 1. Nehemiah chapter 6, beginning in verse 1. Now it came to pass when Sanballat and Tobiah the Geshem, the Arabian, and the rest of our enemies heard that I had builded the wall and that there was no breach left therein, though at the time I had not set up the doors upon the gates, then Sanballat and Geshem sent unto me, saying, "Come, let us meet together in some one of the villages in the plain of Ono." And Nehemiah says, "Oh no." Nehemiah says, "Oh no." "But they thought to do me mischief." Yes. How many know you don't want to make deals with the devil? You don't want to make deals with the devil. "But they wanted to do me mischief And I sent messengers to them saying, I'm doing a great work so that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease while I leave it and come down to you? Yet they sent me four times after this sort, and I answered them after the same manner, I will not come down. I will not come down. Father in heaven, I ask you today to please, I stand here just as honest and open as I can be. I've got to have your touch today. There's no way I can do it without you. I don't want to try, because without you, I am nothing. I am zero without you. Father, I thank you for your help, and I thank you for your mercy. Lord, help me to never allow anything to get me to come off the wall and quit building. Help me to never allow any situation of life or any person in life to cause me to come down to where the enemy is and quit the work of God. And God, I'll give you praise, and I will give you glory, and I will give you honor for it. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And amen. I want you to notice the context of the book and many of the attempts of Nehemiah's enemies to stop him from doing the work of the Lord. How many know that we are ending this thing called life? That it's about over, and the enemy is no dummy. He's smarter than we think. He's very intelligent. In fact, he knows the word himself. He knows the word, and he knows that his time is short. And I believe there's an all-out assault against the church to get us to quit building and come down and cease from doing what God has called us to do. Nehemiah's dedication and service, I believe, stand as a loud witness of what a true servant of God is really all about. I don't mean to be mean this morning, but because you come to church on more Sunday mornings does not make you a real servant of God. Just because we show up here on Sunday morning, it's really no proof to the world that we are really servants of God. And I believe Nehemiah was really a true servant of God. He was very dedicated to what he believed. And Satan and his crowd are always trying to get the servants of God to come down. But when we do, I want to talk to you this morning that there are certain things that we can expect to lose when we come down from the wall. That there are some great and wonderful things that have to be abandoned when we come down from the place of being on building the wall. God has called us to occupy. I don't want you to answer this question. I don't want you to answer it. I really don't. This can either make you kind of happy about yourself, or it can kind of make you say, oh me, what have you done for the Lord this week?
Come on.
Answer that honest question. What have you really done for Jesus this week? Most of us wouldn't want to stand up and say, let me tell you what I've done this week. Most of us wouldn't want to stand up and say, let me tell you what I've done. No, most of us in this place this week have really done very little for the cause of Christ. Amen. And it's either hallelujah or it's oh me. Right. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Right. What have you done
for the Lord this week. He said, I want you to occupy. Or other words, I want you to be doing something until I come. He's called us to occupy. But if we quit building and we come down off the wall, the enemy will win the battle for the souls of men that are before us. So let me talk to you this morning. I just get to spend hours all week thinking and praying and studying about being here. But my week, as I said earlier, has just been a crazy week. And when I got a chance, I got home yesterday. I was physically exhausted, but I poured my heart into this. And I found out, and it may not be the most greatest message I've ever preached, but I still think that I heard from God. You see, if we abandon the work of God and come off the wall, Nehemiah's call and commission was to do a great work. Amen. You know that anything that we do for the Lord is a great work. Anything we do is a great work. It doesn't matter if it's teaching a class or working in the children's department or mowing the churchyard or preaching a sermon or opening a door or picking up a piece of paper on the parking lot. Amen. Anything you do for the Lord is a great work. And Nehemiah understood that he was doing something great. I wish we could understand that and we could get more people on board to work. Because the greatest opportunity you have is to do something for the Lord. Amen. That's the greatest work in all the world. Yes, I like David's attitude about it in Psalms 84:10. For he said, for a day in thy courts is better than 1,000. Yes. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents with wickedness. So what he was saying, he believed it was a great work to stand at the door and let somebody walk into the church and greet them into the house of God. How many believe that anything we do is a great work for the Lord? God help us. So Satan will try every trick in his arsenal to get you to come down. But how many know we just got to keep on building and stay on the wall? James 4:7, the Bible said, submit yourselves unto God and resist the devil and he will flee from you. 2 Peter 3:14, wherefore, beloved, seeing that you look for such things, be diligent that you may be found of him in peace, without spot and blameless. You know, there are people who once was so faithful of working on the wall. They understood the great work that they were doing. But COVID got them off the wall. Don't get me preaching too much here. They were willing to allow that disease called COVID to bring them down off the wall and quit working. And how many know the enemy gained a lot of ground because people allow the mentality of COVID to bring them off the wall and to quit working?
Right.
God help me. There are people that's come down off the wall and quit working because they got hurt a little bit in church.
Come on.
They got their feelings hurt. Somebody didn't talk to him. I don't mind, think she'll mind, and she didn't last Sunday. It bothered me. It really bothered me that my dear sister back here, I thought, I didn't talk to Kathy's mom last Sunday. I didn't talk to her. I didn't shake her hand. And that bothered me. That really did. And I called her on the phone and I said, I'm sorry. I don't think that I shook your hand today. I don't think that I shook your hand. And she said, Oh, Pastor, it didn't bother me. And it, but you know, some people would come down off the wall because the preacher didn't shake their hand on a Sunday. And they stay home from church and quit working because somebody hurt their feelings. Somebody tell me if I'm right or not. Have you ever seen that? People have quit working over the craziest of reasons.
Yeah, they will.
And the enemy wins. Did you hear what I said? The enemy wins.
Yes.
When we come down off the wall. Difficult circumstances made them quit. It's amazing to me how people have come to church when everything's good.
Yeah.
But it seems like when they're going through problems, you don't see them. That's the time to be in church, my Lord. But people come down off the wall. And here's the key to it all. What we need to understand is, the key to it is, when you're working in the kingdom, you're not working for men, but you're working for God. Amen. You're working for the Lord. Can I just be real honest with you? If I'd ever thought in this 40-year journey that I was working for men, I'd have got out of this. Amen. I wouldn't have took the pressure. I wouldn't have took the heartache. I wouldn't took the burden of being a pastor sometimes and the stress that it brings you. Honey, ain't no man could ever hire me to do that. It was a calling on my life. And when you understand what you're doing in the church is not for men, but it's for God, it'll make you want to come to work. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? It'll make you want to get back on the wall. In Colossians 3 and 23, the Bible said, whatsoever you do, do it heartily, as unto the Lord and not unto men. Knowing that of the Lord's, you shall receive the reward of the inheritance. For you serve the Lord Christ. We don't serve men. I don't mean this. How can I say this? Not mean it bad. That's why I can't. I try, but I can't please everybody in the church. Brother Allen, I wished I could please everybody in the church. I remember as a young pastor trying that. I thought, boy, I'm going to be a pastor. I'm going to please. I found out really quick that there ain't no way that I can please everybody in the church. I just can't do that. That's impossible. So I have to understand, and you have to understand, that you don't work for men.
That's right.
You work for the Lord. Hallelujah. Does anybody believe that's the greatest honor on the face of the earth? Is that you get to work for the Lord. Amen. You see, God's plan and His work are just too great for us to abandon them for the devil's foolishness. So we've got to keep working. Not only that, but when we come down and we quit working, we abandon the right way. It seems to have been Nehemiah's manner of life to give himself 100% to his work. To come down would have been to step down. He would have had to turn his back on the right way of what he was supposed to have been doing. You see, when we step down from the Lord's work, we're turning away from the path of righteousness and godliness that God has called us to be. You can't come down off the wall and live right. You can't step down on what God's called us to do and live right. My Lord. God has called us to walk straight. In Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 23, the Bible said, keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Put away from thee a froward mouth and perverse lips. Put far from thee. And let thine eyes look right on, and let thy eyelids look upright before thee. Ponder the path of thy feet, and let all thy ways be established. Turn not to the right hand nor to the left, and remove thy foot from evil. You see, our duty before the Lord is to be faithfully carrying out His commands and do His work efficiently. Joyfully and faithfully, we can't come down. Not only that, but to step down is to compromise. If you come down off the wall, you begin to compromise with this old world. It's not easy to stay on the wall, you know. It's not easy to stay up there, but when you come down, it's when we begin to compromise. And I don't mean to be mean, but there's a lot of the church world that stepped off the world and they become compromising to the world. So when we step down off the wall, we begin to compromise and say things like, oh, it's all right to murder a baby in its mother's womb. You see, when you stay on the wall, you still preach stuff like that. When you stay in doing what God's called you to do, you still preach the truth of the Word of God. I don't know why the Lord put this in my heart, but He did. And it's happening around us. To come off the wall and compromise, we might begin to say things like, it's okay for a man to lay with another man or a woman with another woman. We might even say it's okay to put a little dress or lipstick on your little boy because you were hoping for a little girl.
Amen.
Hello.
Amen.
Yeah. I saw a former college professor in our own denomination this past week on Facebook. As he talked about, he had long hair and makeup on. As he talked about how that we've got it wrong. We've got it wrong. And I wished I could remember all the craziness that he talked about, but he stood there and defended transgenders.
Amen. Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
He once was on the wall. But now you're talking about somebody off the wall. And that's what the enemy wants. He wants us to come from that position of up there doing everything we can for the cause of Christ. To come down and say, well, maybe we need to back off. I won't tell you the whole situation. I won't tell you any of the situation. But I remember weeping this week over a situation that I heard. And I went to somebody and I said, am I too old fogey? Am I too old fogey just to believe that these things are all right? But I'm telling you, if there's ever been a time that we need to stay on the wall.
Amen.
And keep our convictions. Hallelujah. Somebody help me.
Amen.
And keep the morals about us.
Amen.
It's the day in which we live. There's a lot of pastors that's come down off the wall just so they could fill their churches.
Sure. Sure. Come on.
They come down and begin to compromise the Word of God so they can fill their churches. God help me to stay on the wall. Not only that, but when we come down from the wall, we abandon our witness.
Yes.
Nehemiah held a place of great authority and respect among the people. If he had come down, the work would have stopped and many have never finished. And all Jerusalem was watching him.
Yes.
As he led. In Jerusalem, Nehemiah was the leader and the people watched him. And emulated what they saw in their leader.
Amen.
What they saw in him. Listen to what Paul said in 1 Corinthians 11 and 1. Be ye followers of me as I follow Christ. So Nehemiah knew if he began to come down to where they were, people would see him and they would think, well, maybe the work of God's not that important anyway. Maybe it's not important about the church that they talked about. And maybe, preachers began to slip around and do things in front of people that they shouldn't be doing. And people see that. And not only that, but Paul could have led a lot of men astray if he had had come down from the wall, as to speak. Because he said, follow me as I follow Christ. Nehemiah's witness would have been ruined. And the people would have been convinced that there really was a greater work than the Lord's work. So here it is. We need to realize that we are being watched by a growing body of younger, impressionable believers. And if you step down from the Lord's work, you might just cause them to stumble. Amen. God help me. You might just cause them to stumble. You see, I don't mean to be so harsh, but God help me not to be too harsh. But you see, you don't have a right to tell even your children and your grandchildren to not to do things if you do them. Don't let me ever hear a cuss word come out of your mouth. I'll wash your mouth out with soap. But they hear you cuss. Or maybe, now I don't want to be too mean here and hang on, whatever you want to do. But did I find a pack of cigarettes in your drawer? I found a pack of cigarettes in your drawer today, 10-year-old boy. But you light them up in front of them. Yeah. Somebody help me a minute. Somebody help me a minute. See, if you come down off the wall, you begin to lose your witness. And here it is in Matthew chapter 18 and verse 6. But whosoever shall offend one of these little ones, which believe in me, it were better for them that a millstone were hanged about his neck, that he were drowned in the depths of the sea, amen, than to cause somebody to stumble, amen, in their faith. Amen. Somebody amen me or oh me. Or something. That's tough stuff. I know, but Brother Hale used to say, but tight is right. Amen. We got to protect our witness. Because the world is watching us. Your children are watching you. Your grandbabies are watching you. And it's utmost importance that they're able to follow our lead, amen, in the kingdom of God. Amen. It's so important that they could follow our footsteps and then walk with us into the place that we call heaven. Hallelujah. Amen. Because they were able to watch us and emulate us. Amen. And we walked into heaven, yes, together because they watched us live right and holy for the Lord. God help us. God, help us to walk straight in front of the little ones. Amen. The people outside Jerusalem were looking also that were outside of Jerusalem. One false move and Nehemiah's credibility would be destroyed. God, help me. God, help me to always do my very best. And oh, how I have failed sometimes. And oh, how it's the enemy's caused me to do things that could turn somebody aside. Please forgive me. But the people outside Jerusalem were looking also. One false move and Nehemiah's credibility would have been destroyed. The Bible said in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 22, abstain from all appearance of evil.
Yes.
Our lives are going to be so clean and spotless before a watching world.
Amen.
So what can we do? We've got to stay on the wall for Jesus and keep living for Him. In John chapter 6 and verse 63, it is the Spirit that quickeneth, the flesh that profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. But there are some of you that believe not, for Jesus knew from the beginning who they were that believed not and who should betray Him. And He said, therefore I said unto you, that no man can come unto me except it were given him by my Father. For that time many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. Then said Jesus unto the 12, will you also go away? Then Simon Peter answered him and said, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. And we believe and assure that Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Let me tell you, we gotta follow Christ to the end. Did you hear what I said? There ain't nobody else to follow but Christ. And so when we follow Christ, all of those behind us can look and see, hey, that person's genuine. That person is living it. So when we come down from the wall, we abandon our witness. But not only that, when we come down off the wall, we abandon the welfare of the heathen. Jerusalem was known by all, Jew and heathen alike, as the place where God was worshipped.
Amen.
Nehemiah loved God and wanted to rebuild the fallen city, so that God could be worshipped and the lost could be converted unto Him. So to come down off the wall would have been equal to forgetting the eternal danger that the sinner's in. Wow. You see, anytime God is worshipped and proclaimed in truth and sincerity, there's going to be people that get saved. If we just keep lifting up Jesus, souls will be saved.
Amen.
But if we come down from our high calling in Him, we've abandoned the lost and given them up to hell.
Yep. That's true.
When we think church is no more than entertainment.
Come on.
When we think message is need to be no more than a fairy tale.
Come on.
When we believe that preaching ought to be pat you on the back, honey, and go on and live like you want to live.
Come on.
Then we've really abandoned people and said, well, go on to hell.
That's what we're doing. That's it. Yeah.
God help me. God help me. When the preacher's afraid.
Amen.
When the pastor's afraid to upset you a little bit.
Amen.
What I'm saying to you is I don't care where you go.
That's exactly right.
Yeah.
I don't care where you spend eternity.
Amen.
If I ever get to the point where I just, what I'm saying to the lost man or woman sitting in that congregation is I could care less where you go. But Pastor Gann, you can't be so harsh. It's not harsh.
No.
It's the truth.
Amen.
It's the truth.
Amen.
Lord, I've got to get off this high horse. But we've got preachers today that are standing behind the pulpit and telling people, and I know one in particular, not in our denomination, but he's got a church full, that it's all right to drink.
Yeah.
It's all right to sip a little beer or sip a little wine. God help me. Let me tell you something. If you drink beer and sip on wine all week, please don't come here on a Sunday morning and lay your hands on people that are praying in my altar.
Amen. Come on. That's right.
God help me.
Yes.
Because I'm telling you, it's time. And part of my vision, it's time that we really get serious about this thing. Preach the word. In season, out of season.
Amen.
Reprove, rebuke, and I know with all long suffering.
Yes.
And I'm glad he put that in there.
Amen.
Because it hurts me that people are going to hell.
Exactly.
It bothers me that people are going to hell.
Yes.
It bothers me, Brother Bill, that people can come to church and sit on the pew. And still go to hell.
Amen.
Remember the parables about the lost coin and the lost. Where did she lose her coin? In the house.
In the house.
And there's a lot of people that's lost. God help me. God help me. God help me. God help me. There's a lot of people that's lost. In the house.
Yeah, they are. Certainly are.
Say it, brother.
Yeah, they're lost.
And it's time.
Amen, brother.
That we wake up and realize.
Amen. Exactly right.
And if we come off the wall, if I come off the wall as pastor and just start telling people what they want to hear and preaching just some kind of sweet story to them and not doing my best to get them to get saved, I'm going to come down off the wall and I'm going to lose my own salvation.
Exactly right. Come on, brother.
Amen.
God help us.
Amen.
To stay on the wall. You and I are the only light that some people will ever see. Therefore, we must not be dimmed by the world. But we must shine brightly. We're the only Bible that some will ever read. I want you to get that right there. Let me tell you, Mama, and let me tell you, Daddy, and let me tell you, Grandmama, and let me tell you, Grandfather. You're the only Bible that some that maybe your grandchildren will ever read. And what they read in you is what they're going to believe.
Yes.
What they read and see in you is what they're going to believe. Therefore, we got to be clear and we got to be pure. In 1 Corinthians 14:7. The Bible said, and even things without life giving sound, and even things without life giving sound, whether pipe or harp, except they give a distinction in the sounds, how shall it be known what is piped or harped? For if the trumpet give an uncertain sound, who shall prepare himself for the battle? If they don't know. If they don't hear. And it's not declared where they can understand. Who's going to prepare themselves for the real battle ahead of them? Amen. I'm being driven, and I hope that you're being driven. One of the main reasons, not the main reason I want to live right is for me.
Amen.
You know, I got to live right. I know that. But I've got grandbabies that's coming behind me that are, the enemy is growling and snarling and trying to eat them up and put such crazy doctrines in their head and ideology in their head that everything's all right, nothing's wrong. Nothing's wrong. And especially if they see Papa. Especially if they see Papa doing it. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Especially if they see somebody that they adore.
Yes.
Somebody that I hung the moon. You better believe me, I hung the moon to Jovian Thatcher. And if they see Papa do something that ain't right, don't you know that gives them a right in their little heart to say, well, it must be all right.
Yeah.
Because my papa does it. My papa says it. My papa goes there.
Come on. Say it, brother.
Those words come out of Papa's mouth.
There you go.
God help me.
Amen.
We can't come off the wall.
Amen, brother.
Did you hear what I said? We can't come off the wall. Our children are at stake. Our grandbabies
are
at stake.
They are.
And if we come down to compromise with the devil, and one of those little ones stumble, it would be better for a millstone to be hung around my neck. Our duty is clear. Refuse to listen to the calls and challenges of the devil.
Amen.
Stay in the battle for Jesus and don't come down for any reason. We can't come down. We can't come down to a compromising devil. He wants us to sit down and try to compromise with him. Don't come down. Anything other than the perfect will of God is not the place for you to be.
Amen.
You got to be in the perfect will of God. If Nehemiah had come down, he would have been in danger.
Yes.
And you will be too. You got to stay on the wall. You got to finish the task that God will ultimately bless your life.
Amen.
And your effort with.
Amen.
The church as a whole has allowed so many of the enemy's ploys to bring us down from the working on the wall. We've allowed politics to bring us off the wall.
Right.
Now, I'm not talking about worldly politics.
Right.
I'm talking about politics within the church. That people will do whatever they have to do just to get positions. God help me. Can I tell you, I've never served on a board. I've never served on a committee. And one of the reasons is because I've never politicked for a position. I refuse to do that.
Amen.
If God wants me there, I will be there.
You don't have to politic. That's right.
But there's so much of that goes on that brings people off the wall.
Yeah, it does.
Brings them down to deal with the devil. And it gets us in trouble. Amen. So the church as a whole has allowed so many of the enemy's ploys to bring us down from working on the wall and caused the important work of the Lord to cease. Amen. Amen. Lord, help me. Lord, help me. Lord, never help me to say anything that you would not have me to say. But never let me be afraid to say anything that you would have me to say. Don't ever let me back down off the wall. Don't ever let me back down and come down to where the enemy would want to make a deal with me. That if I just quit preaching the truth, that he would let more people come into the church. He would even send them himself if I just quit preaching the truth of the Word of God. So let's don't come down off the wall. Let me ever see a raise of hands in here this morning. Is anybody's grandkids worth not coming down off the wall? Well, is anybody's grandkids not worth come? I'm telling you, you got to stay on the wall. Because you lose your witness. That got a hold of me so much. When I was studying for this, how that you can lose your witness to your own family. To your own grandchildren. Your own babies.
Yes.
If you come down off the wall.
Yeah, you will. That's right.
How many of you got children that you can't afford to come down off the wall? You can't do anything. They got to be able to follow you. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? They got to be able to follow your footsteps. Because if they ever see anything in you, they're going to believe it's all right. They're going to believe it's all right if they see it in you. My Lord, my Lord, would you stand with me this morning? Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Play me something, Brother Danny, please. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. We have a great work to do. We have a great work to do. And the Lord's going to strengthen our hands just like he did the hands of Nehemiah. He's going to help us do it. You can't live this kind of life that I talked about this morning without the Lord's help. You can't stay as holy and right without the Lord's help that I talked to you about this morning. You can't do it. There ain't no way you can do it. It's impossible. We've got to have the hand of the Lord on our life to be able to live such a straight and narrow way. To look not to the right nor to the left. And to work and do everything. You can't do that on your own. It takes the Lord living in you. Brother Buddy Brewer used to say you have to have the do-righter in you to do right. And when you have him helping you, you can do it. You say, well, Pastor, ain't no way I could live that good. You're exactly right. There ain't no way I could quit some of the things that I know I shouldn't be doing in front of my family. You're exactly right. There ain't no way I could stop going to some of the places that I go. You're exactly right. You have to have the Lord to help you and to guide you in all truth, to direct your steps and order your ways. That's the only way you live right, Brother Bill, is by his help. And he'll help you. Did you hear what I said? He'll help you. He'll help you. He'll convict you and he'll let you know. He'll speak to you and direct you in the paths of lives of righteousness if you just allow him to. Just don't come down off the wall. Stay up there. Work. Don't come down to compromise. Compromise anything. Compromise anything. I've got to pastor friends. I've got people, preacher friends that came down off the wall. They thought it'd be all right to come down off the wall just for a little bit. and their lives were destroyed. They didn't guard. They didn't stay up there and keep on working. They came down just long enough for the enemy to make a deal with them. And they lost. They lost. God help me. I'm going to stand here in front of you today again like I did a couple of weeks ago, and I'm going to pray. Father, help me to not come down off the wall, to keep working, to keep building, to keep trusting. Lord, I need you. I can't do it. I cannot do this in myself. And I pray that you'd help me, God. Forgive me for any time that I've come down off the wall and I've said something that hurt somebody, that I've done something that maybe somebody could have seen that and said, well, if it's all right for the pastor to do it or say it, then it must be all right for me to do it or say it. Help me, God, to stay on the wall. Help me to stay pure and holy and righteous in your sight. Because I don't work for men, Lord. I work for you. Help me to please you. Help me to please you, Lord, in everything that I do. And forgive me for any shortcomings that I've had. And help my grandbabies to see in me the way to heaven. Not that it's me, but it's the Christ that lives in me. The hope of glory. That they could watch Papa. And they could follow my footsteps. And I could show them the right way that leads to that place called heaven. And I will love you for it. And I will praise you. In Jesus' name. Is anybody here this morning that you might have come down off the wall? And you know that you're not, your life is not pleasing. You know that you're making deals with the enemy. And the work of God is being ceased in your life. And you know that you need to get back on the wall and you need to get working. And you need to start living right and living holy. Because you don't want your witness to be damaged anymore. You don't want sinners to go to hell, so you're going to lead them the right direction. Is anybody this morning that you might have come down off the wall, but this morning you want to say, God, I'm ready to get back on the wall and I want to work for you. I want to work for you. I want to do everything I can that people will see you in me. Amen. Would you slip your hand up this morning and say, yes, Pastor, that's me. I saw that hand. Is there anybody else? Is there anybody else? Is there anybody else? Is there anybody else? I don't want my family. I don't want my grandbabies. I don't want my children to see anything in me. You know what would probably be all right? If everybody in this place this morning come up and prayed that prayer. I think it'd be all right if everybody in this place come up this and pray that prayer.
Sure.
God help me live a lie that I'm on the wall, that my grandbabies, my children, everybody can watch me and they can follow my footsteps. As Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. Does anybody want to pray that prayer with me this morning? Would you come on up this morning? Does anybody really want to pray that prayer with me this morning? Come on up. 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 Boy, I said some tough stuff this morning. Some really kind of tough stuff. And like I said earlier, I want to live right, so I don't, you know, I don't want to go to hell. You know what I'm saying? That's, I live because you know, I love living for the Lord, and so that's why I do it. But another reason to live right is people are watching us.
That's right. They were looking.
People's eyes are on us. They're really watching. The world's watching us. I'm telling you, Collier loves you to death, man. He's watching you. Their eyes are on us. And if we come down off the wall and we begin to do things that are, they're going to think it's all right. You ruin your witness.
Sure will.
So God, please help me to stay on that wall and keep working and trudging and doing the right things for the kingdom of God. So Thatcher and Jovi can look and say, oh, I want to live like Papa lives. I want to go to the place that Papa's going, and I will spend eternity where Papa's going to spend eternity, in a place called heaven. God, help me. Would you pray that prayer this morning? Father, help me to live. Help me to live that my grandbabies, my children, that they can follow me as I follow Christ. As I follow Christ. As I follow Christ, help me to live in such a manner, God. Help me to be the example in front of them, God, that they can truly watch and follow. And I'll give you praise and glory. And I'll give you honor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, touch Gary today. I pray that you touch Gary. Lord, I pray for him today to just renew and to allow you to strengthen his life and his testimony before you, God. I pray that in Jesus' name today. As he prays, Lord God, help me to live right. Help me to live holy. Help me to live pure. God, I don't want to come down off the wall. I want to spend it working for you, because it's a great work. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Won't you give him praise this morning? He's worthy. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Does anybody need special prayer today? Does anybody need special prayer today?